Hello guys, and welcome back to another episode of Red Dead Redemption 2. Thank you very much for joining me. Today, we are literally just pulling out of the horrible port of that shitey little town. I can never remember the name of it. The one with the lighthouse. You would have seen in the previous episode that we've just literally pulled up on shore after Arthur has made his way back with the gang from Guama. We are now currently just heading out of town. I've stolen a horse because I don't know where our horse is, and there's no stables open right now. You check your map and you'll see that there's like no stables or no like shops or anything like that open at the moment. I believe we're still kind of currently in like within a mission, and I believe Arthur might be getting a little bit drunk at the moment because I did just drink some Guama rum to get his stamina back a little bit. But there's some music going on in the background now. Right now there's some nice music as well, so hopefully that doesn't drown my voice out too much. But we are going back to Shady Bell, the place that we last put up camp with everyone, and we're going to go and look for the gang. As you can see, our mission mark is direct not to that now. Whether they'll be there or not, I don't know. I feel like we could possibly turn up and there'd be no one there because they've had to ship out. And like I said in the previous episode, I'm not too sure why Arthur has been dropped off all this way back if they're already at Shady Bell. But maybe they're just... Well, maybe we're kind of converging. We're just meeting in the middle as such. But we have left Guama. We're officially back in New Hanover. I was speaking to a good friend of mine who also plays the game, who may very well be watching this right now, and talking to him about the fact that there were some discoverable locations on Guama that I didn't get to explore before we progressed on to leaving Guama, getting back to New Hanover. And I tried to reload the save so I could explore those off camera, but I didn't get the chance. It saved me at the beginning of this scene here, rather than save me at the end of the mission. So didn't get to find out what those were all about. I'll have to have a look at some fellow YouTubers' videos, I think, to find out what's going on there. But let's not drag this out any further. I might do a little bit cinematic now and let you guys just watch Arthur make his way to camp, and we'll see where the gang are and how they're doing when we get there. Okay, enough of the cinematics, because we're getting close. We're about to find out if the guys are here, and if they're not here, maybe there's some clues as to where they are. Because it's, well, it's looking pretty damn quiet right now. And I can't really see any signs of people being here recently. I mean, it is raining, so campfire's going to get put out pretty quickly. No smoke. There's some sort of thing draped over the house there, and well, you can see that there are signs that the guys were here, but only signs. And I'm guessing that me and Arthur have got to go and search the house now. I'm just gonna have a little blitz around the outside before I go inside, because could always be a trap. Not that the game wants me to know that, of course. I've always,
Susan?
I've always experienced some really weird noises being in this area. Maybe it's just the rain on... Rain on tin roof. Right. Let's not put it off any longer. I think I'm going to go in my... Have I got my shotgun anymore? No, of course, I don't have my shotgun anymore.
Hello? Anyone here?
Anyone here? It's looking pretty quiet. Food is fresh or looks pretty dead to me. Maybe they had to get a move on as soon as we went missing. They would definitely have known what happened. They all knew that we were going off to do a heist. And they would have heard the talk about the town when everything went badly. I'm expected to get jumped by someone at some point. Anyone here?
Shady. Pearson.
Signs. Well, looks like I'm in the right room.
Every day to search this place.
Oh, shit.
Isn't a gang of outlaws, hold...
It's the Pinkertons.
Those are fresh footprints. Looks like someone might be here right now.
Sure, someone is here. There's always someone everywhere.
Well, let's look around. See if we can find something for Mr. Milton.
Mr. Milton? I'd like to find a poisonous snake for him.
That's enough, Mr. Johns. You take Mr. Bunter and search around back.
Mr. Worley, let's head inside. Gentlemen, be careful.
I wonder if this is going to be a sneaky mission. Or if it's going to be a... one of those runaway missions. It looks like I've got permission to kill. So... I think I'm going to go... I'm probably just going to go loud. Can I get behind him? Oh yes, definitely. Definitely, stay there, don't turn around now. Don't turn around. Oh, you are so dead. You made that one easy for me. Played right into my hands. I wonder if there's any good shit on him. Hang on. I don't think they'll hear me chucking a body about and looting it, will they? No, of course not. Right. So I've got one outside. I don't really want to have to shoot yet. I've got one downstairs and he's looking out the window right now. Let's get my knife out nice and sharpish. I could probably go for either of these guys in the house right now. He's going to turn around. I'm going to come up behind him. Hopefully he doesn't turn around on me.
Found a letter.
No, you didn't. You found nothing. What? Oh, they saw me. Okay. This guy's coming in here. Come on, Arthur. Turn and draw. Christ. There we go. That'll do him. just beat the crap out of a guy with the butt of your pistol through a wall. It's all good. That is simple. Oh, right, okay. I see why we've been queued. As to finding a letter now.
Dear Uncle Tacitus, I do so hope you enjoyed your vacation. Lucky you, leaving like that. And you always suggested you were too old for travel.
Hmm.
I hope you and your cousins enjoyed yourselves. Me and your grandnieces have decided to take a trip of our own, as the place has become so dreary and godforsaken in your absence. We have gone to visit relatives. From my daddy's side, you are not yet acquainted with them, in Lacay, a small village just
it's a small
north
fishing
of Saint-Denis.
Town.
It's buggy and muggy.
Yeah.
But apparently neither is too bad at this time of year. Please, come see us when you can. Yours sincerely,
Caroline.
Well, thank you, darling niece Caroline.
No problem at all. Right, well, we know where we're going now then. Okay, well, I'll tell you what, guys. I will loot these bodies and find any stuff that's laying around here. I'll get back on the horse and I'll cut you back in when we're approaching Lacay. Okay, here we are, guys. On approach to Lacay. It's a bit of a strange name. Proper, like, bayou fishing village. And this is where we came to not hunt the legendary alligator, but when we did the mission that we got attacked. I'm pretty sure this is the area where we came to. It's a really small kind of like abandoned village. I've come here a couple of times and there's nothing to find. But there is, maybe at some point in the story we'll find out more about it, but in that building on my left hand side there, there's actually a hatch in the floor. You can't open it. There's no way you can inspect it or open it. But I assume it's maybe to do with some kind of slave trade or something like that, because there are quite a few hints to that kind of thing around here. But that certainly looks like the large frame of Mr.
Arthur,
Pearson.
Arthur's here.
Oh, Arthur, oh, you're alive.
Just about.
Come inside. Come on, it's raining. You. Hey, everybody, look who's here.
Hey, y'all done? Hey, old man, wake up.
Hey, Arthur, they got John.
Good to see you.
Yeah, he got arrested.
He ain't hung yet?
Not yet. They moved him to Sisica. He's been working on a chain gang.
Howdy.
Oh, look at this.
Yes, they got John.
Okay.
Hey!
How'd you folks find each other? What happened? Can somebody get me a cup of coffee or something?
It was Mrs. Adler who saved us, Dutch. After the robbery in Saint-Denis, she got us away from the camp before the Pinkertons turned up. Then Mrs. Adler and Mr. Smith drove away the degenerates of her living here.
Mrs. Adler, we owe you.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
It's been real hard, Dutch. We've been surviving, but only just. What we gonna do?
Things have been tough. There ain't no doubt about that. Trust me. I am gonna get us out of here. This ain't over.
Ain't none of you folks interested in our adventures?
Guess we're more interested in escaping the hangman on our tail?
Cheerful nymph of the prairie, wasn't you, Abigail?
Oh, sure. My fair heart jumps for joy when I set eyes on you, Micah.
We buried Hosea, Dutch. Charles and I stole his body from the law one night and gave him a proper burial. It was real nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, here you is. Well, I asked everyone I could find, and eventually someone knew, said you fools were out here. Shit. Give me a drink or something.
Get your own damn drink.
In our absence, Mrs. Adler here has been looking after things. Now sit down.
This is Agent Milton with the Pinkerton Detective Agency.
Already?
On behalf of Cornwall Kerosene and Tar, the United States government, and the Commonwealth of West Elizabeth.
Here we go.
We are here to arrest you. Come out with your hands up.
Give them to a count of five, then give them everything. Actually, let them have it.
Here we go.
Everyone get down.
Ask everyone you can find.
Right, we need to take that gunner out. Because this is bad, and it's gonna be a fight now. We're not getting out of this easily. We're gonna have to just shoot this out. Oh, this is the first time I've seen Arthur crawl. He's quite good at crawling. He's better at crawling than swimming, I think. Sadie's gone out the side here, and I think, considering that she's been running things whilst we've been away, I think she's gonna lead us to victory.
Where are we going?
This way. There's a trap door into the other house.
I told you. I told you, there's some reason why that trapdoor is in that house. I've gone back to this house like three times. I don't know why it's there. I can't open it. Now I know.
Get up here.
Yeah, well, what you think I'm... Ooh, I've got my guns back. No, I don't. I've got my pistols back.
Okay. Take the other side.
Okay. Here we go. Here we go. And I think I can get that one. And I'll get... I think that's Milton. Oh. Come on, Arthur. That's not bad shooting there. I've got one left. Whoa. Skadoosh. Is that it? We're gone? No, we still got another. On our left, maybe somewhere. I'm still getting shot out from somewhere. No. I think we're good.
Need to push him back.
Right, where's the rest? They're over the back here. That got me really lost a second there. I'm not liking having my guns back though. That's good to me. I feel like I'm back. Feel like I'm all properly Arthur again. This one's over here. Move to this cover. Whoa. I can't even see them. I just like wait for it to grip up on something and then I shoot. Just missed that guy running. There we go. There's another. Just getting that red X appear out of the distance. Where is he? He's behind a tree somewhere over here. Somewhere over here. Like I say, I really can't see them. Let me move forward a little bit. There's one down there. He's just left of that branch. I've got a mission to say, well, I've got a target to say follow Sadie in the field. There we go. He's gone down, I think. There we go, there's only one more. There he is. This guy is starting to annoy me a little bit. There we go. I think just being on the move and pushing is a good idea. Right, on the Gatling. This is going to be fun. We had big guns last episode, and now we're having even bigger guns. Come on, Arthur! Don't you want to use the Gatling gun? Where are they? Oh my god, oh my god. They're everywhere. Ooh! Okay, it's got some kick to it. Oh, it's a bit difficult to aim. Oh my god, it's like an army. Oh Christ, it's like an army. It's definitely a one-shot kill though, that does help. Hey you, oh my Christ. I'm just kind of tap firing at the moment. As you can see, it's like, it might be a one-shot kill, but I've still got with some. There we go. I think I've got them all. I think. Yes.
You saved us, Arthur.
Oh, me and Bill and Sadie.
You okay, son?
Sure. We ain't been back for more than a few days.
What do we do, Dutch? Clearly, we need to leave. It'll take them some time to regroup. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw, start packing up. Javier. You and Bill, get out of here. Go scare off any scum still loitering about. We need a couple of days. Now, please, gentlemen.
Sure. What next, Dutch?
We just need some time. I need some time. Now, we can't go east, because then we'll be in the ocean, so we're going to have to go north, I guess. I just need somebody to buy me some goddamn time, one of you.
You'll figure it out, boss. You always do.
What are you going to do about John, Dutch?
John?
He's in jail.
We'll get him. Abigail, just not yet.
There's talk of hanging him.
It's not going to come to that.
Dutch!
Not now, Miss. Not now.
I'm begging you two. They're going to hang him and break my... the boy's heart. Please, do something.
We will. Okay. I'm going to go figure out how we rescue this bastard. Yes, now. Give me a Doyle's Tavern, a Million Avenue.
Okay. My lord, what a goddamn mess. Everything. Not sure what happens next. Whole thing has been hard on all of us. Most of all on Dutch, who seems half crazed by all we've gone through.
Well, there you go, guys. That is kind of... I guess that kind of wraps everything up from the Guama chapter.
Good morning.
Pretty culminated in a pretty big fight. And by the sounds of things, we didn't get Milton because they're off. They're like Dutch said, oh, you know, chase them off and, you know, go and pursue them and buy us a couple of days' time. You know, hopefully we've got the Milton character. Because I guess if we get the boss man, then maybe we might, you know, get some time to figure things out. But by the looks of things, if I go up to Kato, because Kato was my horse before I left. Okay, we can't access our guns in camp. Hang on, let's have a little ride out of camp. Let's have a spin on Kato, see how he's doing. Charles has had a different haircut, I think. He's got like kind of like a Mohican like ponytail thing going on. But by the looks of things, yes, we do indeed have all of our rifles back now. It's the first time in a long time that we've got all of our bits and pieces, all of our guns with our attachments and stuff like that, which is nice and familiar. And I have my hat back, which is probably the thing that I've missed the most. Arthur's shabby hat. Now, Arthur's looks like he's a little bit under the weather, so I'm guessing the story's going to progress in that way a little bit more, but, I think for this episode, guys, we will leave it there. I've promised shorter episodes for the past three episodes, and it just hasn't worked out the way the game's been playing, but I've got the opportunity to end it here at about 25 minutes, so I think that'll work out well. I think that'll be a nice watchable episode for you guys, so thank you for tuning in. Do leave a like on the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe for next week's episode, and you can obviously tap the notification button to get the notifications when we upload and when we stream. And I will see you in the next episode of Red Dead.